Why is space extremely cold despite the scorching heat of the sun? We have all wondered why space is freezing cold despite the sun's scorching heat. The answer is actually quite simple and straightforward. We feel the heat that comes from the sun, which is 150 million kilometers away from us, every day. If the sun is so hot, why is space so cold? To learn the answer to this question, we need to know two terms, heat and temperature. Heat is a type of energy related to the amount of matter, while temperature is just a measure. When heat is transferred to an object, the object's temperature rises, and when heat is removed from an object, the object's temperature drops. These transfers occur in different ways. How does temperature transfer work on objects? This heat transfer occurs in three ways: conduction, convection, and radiation. We see conduction type of heat transfer in solid materials. When the particles that make up solid objects heat up, their vibrations increase. During this process, they collide with each other, transferring heat from hotter particles to cooler ones. The reason why we burn our hands after touching a hot iron rod or an iron spoon that touches a hot object is due to this type of heat transfer. We witness convection type of heat transfer in liquids or gases. When the fluid is heated, molecules rise and carry heat energy with them. For example, the radiators in our rooms work on this principle of heat transfer. The radiation method is different from these two processes, and heat is spread through light waves. All objects emit thermal energy radiation at a certain level depending on their temperature. At room temperature, we and everything else emit heat in the form of infrared waves. In this way, people's fever can be measured with thermal cameras. Therefore, heat transfer occurs not with matter particles, but with waves. That's why the sun's energy reaches Earth from 150 million kilometers away. Heat is a matter-related subject. Space is a vacuum where no matter exists. It is impossible to talk about heat transfer through conduction or convection. Naturally, we cannot talk about heat transfer since there are not enough particles in space. This transfer seems possible only through radiation. When the sun's radiation hits an object, the atoms that make up the object begin to absorb energy, and this energy starts to produce heat as the atoms vibrate. The temperature of objects in space does not change for a long time. To put it simply, since there are no particles in space, the temperature does not change. For example, even if a rock is heated until it boils with solar rays, it will eventually cool down to its old temperature. Because this heat is easily lost because it cannot be transferred to anything in empty space. The answer to our question emerges: space is actually very cold because there is nothing to absorb the energy that comes from the sun. We don't need to go to space to feel this difference. The side of the Earth that does not see the sun is relatively colder. However, fortunately, thanks to the atmosphere of our Earth, it is not close to absolute zero compared to other celestial bodies that do not have an atmosphere. Otherwise, we would not be able to talk about life. As an example, let's take the Earth's satellite. The temperature on the side of the moon that is constantly exposed to the sun is around 127 degrees. However, the temperature drops to minus 173 on the dark side of the moon. So, what is the temperature of space? Scientists say that the temperature in space is minus 270 degrees. However, this is only an average temperature. It is also known that different parts of space have different temperatures, according to research. Since there is nothing to absorb the energy that comes from the sun, space is very cold despite the scorching heat of the sun. I am Samet Ozelp. Thank you very much. If you want to delve deeper into the topics you understood, you can find many more interesting videos on our channel. Also, if you want to learn more about the topics we cover in our videos, you can check out the sources in the description section. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications so you can stay informed about future uploads. Additionally, if you have any comments, suggestions, or questions about the video, please share them with us in the comments section. Your feedback is important and valuable to us. Thank you again, and see you in the next video.